He knocks himself out.
Dude, this exchange right here is so smooth and quick and powerful.
If you guys are wondering as filmmakers what not to do, here we are.
Thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring today's episode. Stick around to the end to find out how you can get 10% off your first purchase.
Hey everyone, we are back here with Stuntman React with the man that started it all with us, Eric Linden. You're probably wondering where he was these past couple months. Eric, where were you?
I've been quarantining like everybody else, and I just had a baby in November, so I've literally just been smashing weights and changing diapers for the last 5 months.
That's so great.
It's been amazing.
There's some clips that I've been saving just to show you.
I'm so excited.
Yeah, I'm so excited too. Let's jump in.
Follow me.
What is this?
Clint, you didn't see Birds of Prey?
What is this?
This is a perfect example of something that looks good on paper. In reality, it's just god-awful. Rosie Perez should never throw a punch, ever. I've worked with Margot. She's actually very good. She does some stuff here that's pretty cool, but unfortunately, this movie doesn't show it.
None of these hits are like takedown hits, but they're all being acted as if they're takedown
hits. Nothing feels like it hurts.
Okay, here's what it is. It's like the stunt performers, these bad guys coming in, they're coming with 100% energy, and they're just going in for a flip, you know, just for a fall. The actors here are just throwing their legs out.
The stuntman's job is to make the actor look good. They're throwing mediocre kicks and punches, so the stuntman sells it and makes him look really powerful. But I think this scene is a great example of that going too far. The stuntmen are doing their best to sell these hits, and they're doing flips and taking these crazy smashes. You're just not seeing that from the actor's side. Like, they're just not at all delivering the kind of hits to sell the reactions that the stuntmen are given.
If you guys are wondering as filmmakers what not to do, here we are.
Eric, what would you do? What's the number one thing that you would do that would serve the most impact and get the scene that much closer to 100%?
I would use stunt doubles. I mean, my goodness. They probably did not give them enough time training. If they did have enough time, they may have reached like the peak of their talent, and that's where you need to utilize stunt doubles, because it's not their fault. They're there to act. I'm not expecting them to be amazing at action, but when it's time to step off, just let the person that's a professional get in there and do it.
iCarly has some...
You say iCarly? I
know, you see. That's right, iCarly has a hard hit, man.
I forgot Gibby.
Oh yeah. Gibby!
Gibby! He knocks himself out.
Dude, he bounces!
When he hits the ground, it's like he bounces and then his soul stays here. His body lands on the ground, then he's like...
That's such a great effect.
Oh, man.
Oh my God.
I heard he broke a rib doing this scene. You can tell he's just unconscious the way he hits.
Yeah.
And how are they standing there composed? Yeah. I shouldn't be laughing.
That is all real, and he's not on a wire. They just drop him.
Oh my God.
There's no foam padding. He just hits the concrete.
Dude, what?
You know, I've done things that are similar to that, and you kind of like have your knee pads on, hard knees, hard elbows, and you want to land 4 points of impact, and you're probably like up there, like hanging, like, okay, I'm ready. And they're like, 3, 2, no!
What's going on here? What? Okay, driving a car through a ravine.
Is that Michael Douglas?
Yeah.
What are we gonna do now?
Oh, what? There's people in there? No.
Whoa!
What?
He didn't get out! He started to jump.
They did this for real. They just literally just send this thing over the waterfall. I mean, there's nothing necessarily controlling it, and you get to the point where you're just going for it.
So you better not land on that car.
Or underneath it.
How do you make that as safe as possible? Check for rocks, I guess?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the water safety guys and scuba guys, they all, I'm sure, went down, checked the terrain, make sure there was enough room for it to be as safe as possible. They're in a real waterfall, so Terry got sucked under and had to get saved by the safety divers.
Oh my God.
Wow. Yeah, saved his life.
Wow, that's insane.
You know, this is a perfect example. Sometimes you can rehearse a fight scene for a really long time and become an expert at it and pull everything off, and then there's some scenes where you just have to be a stuntman, and this is it. The person doubling Michael Douglas, his name is Vince Dedrick Jr. And fun fact, he's the guy that does iCarly.
Really?
Give me!
Wait, that's the same guy?
Same guy. The person doubling Kathleen Turner is a guy.
Oh, really?
It's Terry Leonard. He's a legend. You can't do that now. It's like called wigging. The time that they have done it, I believe most recently, before it kind of became like a faux pas, was Kick-Ass. Hit Girl is a little Asian man who is doubling her for all of the hallway run scene. And it's amazing, but like literally you can't do that.
Guys, we are only 95,970,000 subscribers away from hitting 100 million subscribers. So definitely take part in subscribing to this channel. It helps us out a lot. And we're gonna get to 100 million together. We're gonna beat T-Series. We're gonna beat PewDiePie. It's gonna be easy with your help.
So we had a master swordsman, Luke LaFontaine, come in here and he broke down a bunch of fight scenes with Scott Atkins. Scott, if you happen to be watching this, love to have you on the show if you'd be interested. I guess this is an early clip that you're gonna show us from one of his movies.
Yeah, I know you guys talked about Scott previously and how amazing he is, but I thought it would be fun to smash on him just a little bit and take it back to the beginning and show how far Scott and Michael J. White have come as stunt performers, martial artists, and just filmmakers in general, because this is atrocious.
Oh man.
Scott, we love you, but as a brother, we want to make fun of you a little bit.
And now Gia, and all the others have taken the fall. Only you and I are left.
You know, I've said this, I think, before, big pet peeve. Just ridiculous, like out of nowhere 360 that doesn't advance your position whatsoever and doesn't help the fight at all.
Hey, Michael throws a little 360 of his own.
Another one.
It definitely feels like theatrical.
Yeah.
You know,
I don't have any problem with 360s in film, but they need to have a purpose. You know, a lot of this, they are swinging to miss. Their swords are just clacking out here in the middle instead of it like coming over here to where there would be some sort of danger, and that I then block it and it appears as if I just saved my life.
When Luke was talking, you know, when it comes to real sword fighting, it's about time. You know, it's you want to make it so that your time to get your weapon in for the kill strike is shorter than the time it takes theirs to do. So Scott does the same move twice here, where he hits once from the side, and he just pulls his sword back a little bit and goes for another hit. And Michael Jai White, rather than just keeping sword there and blocking twice, takes the sword and flips the whole thing upside down. And that's just a good example where like that defensive move takes so long that the offensive move just looks awkward waiting for it.
The other thing is, even though you know the moves, you need to appear as though you don't. So the best thing to do is keep your eyes on what's happening, and you need to see it coming towards you and then initiate the block, because that's how a fight really goes. You see something happen and then you react to it.
I mean, there's a lot of ways to approach a sword fight, but there's kind of like two things I feel like make a sword fight pretty, at least when I approach the occasional sword fight that I've filmed. One is, you know, when you're clashing swords, you go for like the rebound of energy. So like if you're coming in for a hit and you hit and you bounce and you let that bounce take you into the next hit. The other method is you go and you hit, and then after the hit, you then knock the weapon away. With each version, you're dealing with a momentum that's like flowing through the fight, but this fight doesn't really have either of those. So the moves don't really flow into each other from a kinetic point of view.
So now we go hand to hand.
That cat stance.
Look at that swim!
Wait, hold on.
What was that, dude?
Like, what was that gonna do?
That's like the yo-yo kick.
This fight scene just needs to be practiced more so that the choreography disappears.
Yeah, I'm not sure the choreography would disappear here, though.
Some of this stuff, you could make it look better. It's just a performance thing. It just goes to show you how far these guys have come as performers. Obviously, they got way, way better. Yeah, so anyway, hopefully you enjoyed us kind of like smashing on Scott a little bit. We were gonna go through all the stuff that makes him look super awesome and amazing, but I'm gonna let him just come on the show and do that himself. So Scott, feel free to come on here and completely redeem yourself. We love you.
Hey guys, a lot of these clips that we see in the show are inspired from the things that you found, so I have a request for you for stunts here. Please leave a suggestion down below of the coolest stunt from a foreign film that you have seen. That way we can look for some clips here that might be unseen by a lot of our audience and shed some light on how they're made. We're gonna cap this off with a piece that Eric made.
Yeah, so the story behind this thing is I directed this in between Punisher season one and season two.
Dude, sick. Nice. Oh, man.
So he's like very quick and deliberate with his shots.
Yeah.
It's not too flashy. Oh, nice. That was a nice little exchange right there.
Yeah, you're the guy who just gets manhandled.
That's awesome.
I really like how you flow through the movement. You know, you get hit and that inspires you to take a shot from the hip, and then like you have to fall backwards while keeping your eye on the guy. Like,
yeah, well, actually right here I miss, and that was choreographed on purpose because everybody just is so perfect. Like I want to like try to like be firing and recorrect and then get my shot online.
Yeah,
nice.
Another thing people don't pay attention to, I was trying to prove that I did, was that specific gun holds 9 bullets in the clip and 1 in the chamber when it's racked. So this whole run I shoot exactly 10 bullets.
Heck,
that's
yeah.
Cool. So because you're wearing a face mask, are you just going pew 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 pow pew pew underneath the whole time?
You know, I feel like everybody's timing's really on, and part of the reason that was is because I brought an armorer in, and they're not airsoft guns. We were shooting blanks. It was super loud. Like the first run I did was completely screwed up because I fired and I was like, oh God. knew I was using blanks, but just was surprised at how loud it was going to be. So everybody was able to react to the actual gun firing. Also, we could use some of the muzzle flash to help us with embellishment in CG.
Yeah. Another thing I liked about that little scene is that you are establishing the geometry and using that geometry. Like when you go behind the container, the other guy's around the corner and he goes to look where you were and you just do the simple flank maneuver to the other side. That's the thing I really miss in a lot of gunfights in film is that usually just show a guy shoot, show a guy get shot. But the use of the layout of a room as the puzzle that you're presented with as a person trying to do a gunfight, that's what makes gunfights interesting. Otherwise, you're just watching explosions happen on different sides of a screen. Where would people go if they wanted to see the whole thing?
We put it up on FX and post, fix it in post, who did scene 38.
Oh, same guy.
With mine.
Huh.
Okay, look, while the guys are out filming another Stuntman React episode, I've got something I need to get off my chest. Eric, I'm gunning for you, man. And I know that you have the top spot as Stuntman de excellence in this whole series, but I gotta say, that spot, that's my spot. That's right, and courtesy of today's sponsor, Squarespace, I've created one of the most robust training montages that anyone's ever seen. The guys are gonna be willing to give me my own episode. Now maybe you have your own services and you need a great online website. Or maybe you have your own store and you need a great store. If you're looking to do something new this year or to do something robust, consider using Squarespace to help you do it. They are award-winning just like this training montage. That's right, they have beautiful award-winning templates. They also have 24/7 award-winning customer service. Next thing you need to know, Squarespace has wonderful traffic overviews tools that give you analytics on everything related to your site. Just like the big boys do, Squarespace has you covered. You're like, Jake, I need to take it to the next level, just like your training montage. Well, guess what? Squarespace has you covered once again. If you're looking to do email campaigns to your direct audience through your site, Squarespace can allow you to craft beautiful templates to send out to specific parts of your site audience. It's a very good thing to have, just like this training montage. So if you guys are interested in getting 10% off your first purchase, head on over to squarespace.com/corridorcrew, and that's exactly what you'll get. That's squarespace.com/corridorcrew, or click the link in the description below. What do you think of my stunt reel? My training montage?
Eric, thank you so much for coming out. I missed you. It's been so long. I haven't been able to see you because of the pandemic or anything. I'm glad I finally got to play these clips for you that I've been holding on to for like months and months and months. It's crazy. Like, Between when you were here and you helped us start the show and now, it's like totally transformed what we do on this channel.
It's a different world, man. It's crazy. I'm just glad everybody really likes what's happening over here. I think you guys have had amazing guests on.
And, thank you.
I think it kind of shows the stunt community as a whole. And thanks for having me back. Hopefully we brought some stuff that's interesting to you guys, and I felt like we all got a kick out of it.
Yeah, dude, thanks for coming back, man. So if people want to check out your stuff, you're on Instagram at Eric Linden.
Yep.
And then you have ericlinden.com.
That's correct.
But Eric, thanks again for coming on, dude. I freaking love you, man. It's so good to see you.
Awesome. Yeah. Good to see you guys.
Good to see you too, man. Yeah.